was that?
You getting all these guys in that ghost prison of yours?
Most certainly. Exemplary ghost hunting, Officer Jones.
Thanks. It's just that, I don't know, man. I get the feeling I'm mowing down the good guys.
You are under fire, Officer Jones. What choice do you have? This is a totally valid part of your mission. Presumably. But your scruples are inappropriate. These are ghosts. Unlike your encounters in the swamps, these soldiers are not alive.
Oh!
was going on?
Got a yak in the tank. Well, blame his sideways. Uncle Sam said he more so is, eh?
Hey, can it? I got the gun and it's pointed at your neck. You just tell me where I am and who the hell you are.
Yes, yes, just a moment. Cold. Colder. Left. That's it. Warm. Warm. Hot, yes. Jolly good show. Colonel Freddy Ford is still 3rd Regiment of Royal Horse Artillery at your service.
Well, Colonel, just what exactly are you doing here, playing soldiers in this junked-up bathtub?
Why, I'm haunting it, of course. Mission is to protect His Majesty's gold, sir.
Gold?
Why, yes. HMS Victoria, commandeered liner, ferrying troops and supplies. The spoils of war, don't you know? Sunk in 45. Been battling for the gold ever since.
But you're dead.
Pish and baloney. The Fortescue family have been fighting man and boy for old Blighty for over 1,000 years. And we've never let a little thing like death get in the way of a good scrap. Why, there's a Fortescue on every battlefield of the civilized world. Agincourt dead, Waterloo dead, Dunkirk dead.
All right, I get the point. But who are you fighting against?
Who's her? What, sir, if you don't mind? The beast, plaguing the ship. Haven't you seen it? Mind, did start off as a chap, I suppose.
I don't understand.
All in my dispatches, no time for that now. Use the wireless of all things, recording cylinders, just the job. You'll hear the whole damn yarn.
This beast wouldn't happen to be a ghost, too.
I'd nod my head if it wasn't such a damn wrinkle.
And I guess it's the reason I'm here.
Turned out our cargo had more to it than met the eye. It was under strictest orders to keep safe and keep secret. A certain gold statue our chaps had won back from the Nazis. The dagger of Poseidon, worth a king's ransom apparently, but infamous too. Surrounded by a lot of spiritual mumbo jumbo. That godforsaken sea dog, Captain Kraken, was furious when he knew it was aboard. Never take the dagger of Poseidon to sea, Captain, my lord. But now I know what I know, and here we all are. Ghosts. We could do with a chap like you. Had a yank alongside once before. Jolly good, eh?
Really?
All in my dispatches. Now then, by the looks of Alpha and Delta team, you haven't exactly been helpful to the cause.
I'm sorry, I think I put a few of them out of action.
Chin up, soldier. They've gone to a better place.
Maybe.
It's over. Well, I'll call my men off pronto. Nothing worse than friendly fire. As Nanny used to say, don't bash Bernie, he's your brother. Ah, here's the plan. Going to dynamite the enemy. Foolhardy scheme, but desperate times and all that. The beast down in the engine. But now, a good soldier adapts to the situation and never gets caught out twice. So you could just...
Alpha team reporting in. The intruder was seen entering the bridge at 0800 hours. Colonel Fortescue is MIA, assumed compromised. Intruder is extremely dangerous and must be faced with extreme prejudice.
What are these things? Thank you. Need some TNT.
Bloody civvy at the helm. Who or what is this godforsaken Captain Kraken? Never liked the look of him. Should have known he was rotten. Third day at sea, refused a friendly game of deck quoits. Shuffles about the blasted bridge as if he owns the place. His fat, pus-ridden face looming. His one bulging eye peering up at you. Blighter sat out the war, naturally, bloody coward. Comes out of the woodwork now to steer a ship full of gold. Ha! Keeps on and on about seeing the cargo. Doesn't seem to understand the term top secret. Bad egg.
Thank you.
2021. By jigger and crud, how right I was about the bog-eyed traitor Kraken. Height of the storm, suddenly three bells ring, and his crew attack. We fight back, yes, and how we fought. My boys were lions, did his majesty proud. But those cutthroat tars were quite a handful, I can't deny. My duty lay with the cargo, of course. And I was there before you could say, hi, Jimmy Knacker. But so too was Kraken, with some sort of cleaver in his hand. But it seems the dagger of Poseidon is what the whole damn scrap was about, the greedy blackguard. Freddy Fortescue wasn't going to let him get it. No, no, no. At least not the way he wanted it. But in the tussle, by jingo, he did get it. He got it right in the belly. Now, a dagger, statue or no statue, gold or no gold, to the belly isn't good news for a chap. And so down went Kraken, swiping his cleaver about his bulging eye, never leaving the dagger of Poseidon jammed in his breadbasket. The curse, he whispered. The curse. Not the greatest of last words, I was thinking, when I looked up and realized it was time for my own. Oh, ass, as I recall. You see, I was looking up and seeing my own body charging about without a blooming head. Kraken's cleaver had swiped it off. Damn useless. Worse still, in the melee, down goes HMS Victoria. Glug, glug, glug. Davy Jones's locker, what? Turns out, though, that wasn't the end for us. Hurrah for the haunting life, huh? And, of course, us British ghosts don't give up a tussle. Oh, no. And neither did Kraken's motley lads. And so the fight rages on. But Kraken just slinks there in the corner, slime-covered, watchful, attracting the urchin. 29. 2 days ago it started. As each of Kraken's sailors fell, their spirits seemed to get sucked into his slimy carcass. By the hour, he became stronger and stranger, too. Tentacles and fangs, a horrific sight. Kraken is now unrecognizable, a monster of the deep. Grows by the day. This is a fight fit for a Fortescue! Hurrah!
Thank you. exactly what I'm required to do. There's a word for it. Stupidity.
Why don't you just leave him alone? He's nothing.
He's hardly that.
You know his luck's gotta run out soon, so get him out of there before it's too late. Throw in someone who's got what it takes. You hear me? Let him go and I'll take over. Okay? You don't need both of us.
How quaint. I do believe you're starting to care for him. I shouldn't become too attached.
You're really a jerk, you know that? And I should know. I've met plenty.
Or perhaps you should allow yourself to become enamored. After all, he's doing all this in order to find you, yes? Keep looking on in admiration. I propose a simple arrangement. When I have he can have you.
Oh, yeah?
And I am a man, a monster, of my word.